While the coastal areas make you come to terms with change, the mountains help you understand why some things are set in stone. This chapter of Getting There, I'm back on the Royal Enfield Continental GT in Shillong. My guest is Auditya Venkatesh, technically a photographer, but mostly a doer of things. He shot films, the night sky, and even me. He has a cult following among picture takers. A guy not defined by the tools he uses, but what he creates with them. In the age of people boasting about their lenses and what cameras they have, Audi mostly prefers his phone. And he's also our first guest who rode along with me. Knowing you and we did, before we get too far away, I need to clear my mind. I'd rather just tweet it and delete it. Because you didn't want to be a photographer, I think you're not bound by the rules. Like, to be honest, when you meet, I watch all these videos of this famous Time magazine, I don't know his name, the guy who does all the Time magazine portraits. He's like, I need my this camera, I need my this light. You're the only guy I know who's like, yeah, I shoot on my phone, and you openly say it. Because I didn't know the rules of stand-up, I did music and acting in it. And then other comedians told me that, why are you doing this guitar thing, why are you doing this music? And I'm like, hello, no one told me you can't do it. So I think you also have that same thinking that, don't define me as a photographer. So if you don't define me as a photographer, I'll use anything to make a photo.
Yeah, what starts happening with me also, right? I mean, when I started making a little money and I could afford the good gear, and I had it, I started realizing it started making me very comfortable.
Yeah.
In a sense that if I only had one lens and one camera, then I would shoot.
Yeah.
Or if I saw something nice, I'd be like, oh, I wish I had that lens, but I wouldn't do something with what I saw.
Yeah.
And that's like not a great place to be in as a photographer, because if you see something interesting and something that you'd like to document, you don't go, oh, I wish I had that lens, then I will do it.
Yeah.
You try to do whatever you can with what you have.
Yeah.
So for me, that's when I started shooting a lot more on phones.
Okay.
It teaches you discipline. It's like shooting with a prime lens, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you have one lens and that's it. Like, you have to move, you have to reframe, you have to walk around, and you have to work within those restrictions. I hear them talking about us.
I can hear them thinking out loud. I was just like, man, the big problem is quality versus quantity.
So I mean, it's like challenging yourself.
Yeah.
But also being trying everything that comes to your mind.
Yeah. Okay with not it being perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's, so one of them told me this, it's pretentious perfectionism.
Yeah.
Where in your head you build it up so much
that
you're not even true to yourself anymore, so you're being very pretentious, but you're also chasing something that can't be done.
Yeah.
And the only way to keep getting better is by working on something constantly. And also it's, if you started out to do something, right?
Yeah.
Whether it's shooting images or making people laugh or creating content,
then
you should be doing that and you should be sort of getting better at it and doing different things and experimenting, because if you maybe stick to that formula, then you just stay there and it stagnates after a while. You hit a ceiling, the people who consume your work or people who, you know, interact with you.
Did you do that actively? Like at some point you were like, oh, I think people think I only do this one thing.
Actually, initially, I think one of the changes that I had to make was people thought I was an aggregator of images. So they thought, Audi Photography, I would sit and collect photos from the internet and put them up. Nobody knew that there was a person. And then that became really confusing. Because I'd get 100 messages a day saying, hey bro, here's my pic put up, here's my credit. I'm like, no man, this is for my work. He's like, no, but this is so many different photos and so many different places. I'm traveling to these places.
Oh, wow.
So then I spoke to somebody and then they said, look, as an artist, you are a brand of yourself.
Okay.
And your work is an extension of what you do, but people need to know that this is from a person, because right now you need to avoid that. That is when I started putting my face out there more and getting people not to just connect with my work, but the person behind the work.
Simplest way of storytelling. Start at sunrise and at sunset. When I was directing and you work with like DOP who's much better than you, like obviously because they're older and they're more experienced, I have to do this thing called don't make your portfolio, make the movie. And it's very hard because every point of the process, I have to make sure that, no, don't make your portfolio, don't make your art portfolio, don't make your DOP portfolio. It's a very thankless job, because the better you do, the more invisible you become.
I think, yeah, that's all the sort of top directors and DOPs, that's the one thing you always hear them say.
Yeah.
Is I don't want ever someone to come and say, this department was great.
Yeah.
Because then it goes to, but these things fell apart.
Yeah.
You know, because if there's something that's a great product, everything's seamless, everything fits in, and that's when it becomes a really great film.
Yeah.
But the
there's a lot of no's on set.
Yeah.
A lot of like, no, and you have to not take it personally.
Yeah, and then you've learned those things also, like, yeah. So with your people skills, and you're then coordinating with so many more people on set, and, yeah. You know, all those things that play into this. It'll be a slow process. I think what got me interested in video was actually the time I spent in Chennai,
yeah.
On film sets and watching movies and speaking to directors and actors, yeah. And all of that. And that's when I was like, oh, this is something interesting.
But doesn't it annoy you that every film is not beautiful? Could be more.
That's what I mean. That also something, like you said, no?
Yeah.
Initially, every picture that you try to make,
yeah.
is a journey towards just that one frame.
Yeah.
But then you have to understand, in a film, like, that's just a, like, there's movement, there's so many different other things that happen.
Yeah.
You can't be fixated on just that one thing. While you want to do your best,
yeah.
you have to work around all your limitations and make sure you get the shot that the director wants, but not the most beautiful shot for yourself. Okay, it can be beautiful, but if it doesn't tell the story the way the director wants, then it's pointless.
Like, you know, when a DOP has cut a trailer, only the beautiful shots are there, yeah. and you have no idea of the story. Like, there's an out of focus shot in the foreground, and you're like, why is this in the trailer?
Yeah, and they'll be like, no, this tells you something about, you know, the fuzziness of this.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's...
That's like on painting, dude.
Yeah, I told you, this, it'll change.
Oh, sure, it changed more, man.
Yeah. This can I quickly run there and come back? Oh, are we in the middle of a conversation?
What?
Can I run there and come back quickly? Holy
follow
Audi. Man, this is insane. Now.
This project has enabled me to talk to my favorite kind of people. People who do first and think later. Audi constantly questions the rules to a point where he ends up making new ones and then he breaks them again. Why punish yourself while pursuing your heart? Wasn't the idea to love what you do and not question why you do it?
Thank you so much for watching the video. I had a blast talking to Auditya in Shillong. If you had a very memorable motorcycle road trip with somebody special, please write about that experience in the comment section below using the hashtag getting there. The best stories will win some Royal Enfield merch. Yeah, so there's a reward and incentive. Please like, share and subscribe as usual. Hope you like the series.